Hi, I'm Ian Thane, and this is SAP Developer News.
At the end of last week, we received the announcement that SAP TechEd in 2021 wants to again be a global, virtual, and free event, and it will be taking place on November 16th through the 18th. We can also share that we once again have a DevToberfest celebration leading right into SAP TechEd. Now, public details are a little sparse on both these events right now, but believe me, we have some really great new and fun ideas and that we're working on, and we can't wait to share all the details with you. You can tune in here to the SAP Developer News each week for the latest and what is planned for both events. But in the meantime, you can already take action if you want to be part of the SAP TechEd content. The call for proposals for SAP Community Talks at SAP TechEd 2021 is now open. This is your opportunity to make your story and experience part of the SAP TechEd and to share that with the rest of the SAP community. All the instructions and guidelines for submitting your community talks are detailed in the blog post linked in the description of this video. And finally, on the subject of the SAP community, we are also happy to share that our fellow organization of community advocates just launched their own SAP community news program over on their YouTube channel. If you like what we do here in SAP Developer News, keeping you up to date weekly, but also want the same sort of thing for the whole scope of the SAP community and the people that make that community possible, then you'll also want to subscribe to their news program as well.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, Developer Advocate, SAP Devs. And since we have so much news this week, I thought I'd have my sidekick Sully join us for today. This week, Florian Wall wrote a blog post announcing the SAP BTP ABAP environment, release 2108. This new release brings a ton of new features to many different aspects of the ABAP environment. Firstly, we now have support for key user extensibility in multi-tenancy scenarios, which allows configuration of predefined fields as well as registration and implementation of baddies. The new ABAP SQL Service binding type is now available, which allows developers to expose CDS view entities to ODBC-based SQL clients. And additionally, an ODBC driver is now included as well. There has been several enhancements to the XCO library, including reading of function modules, changing interfaces, and querying transformations, just to name a few. We have several new features related to ADT and a new class for working with ranges. There are many new enhancements to the ABAP RESTful application programming model, new enhancements to administration type applications, as well as business configurations. Check out Florian's blog post for more details on all of the new features in 2108. Also this week, Andre Fisher posted a blog post about generating SAP Fiori table maintenance dialogues using the wrap generator. With the latest update to his wrap generator, there is now support for all the features needed to generate an SAP Fiori app that supports multi-inline capabilities, self-registration in the business configuration app, and automated code change recording and customizing transports. For more information on this topic and step-by-step instructions, check out Andre's blog post.
The SAP Fiori Elements team published a blog post last week that went through the roof. In her latest post, Stephanie introduces you to the new flexible programming model to extend SAP Fiori Elements applications for OData V4. This post gives you an excellent overview of the following three options to extend Fiori Elements applications: extension points to add custom artifacts such as sections and columns, building blocks, which can be seen as an evolution for the smart controls for OData V2, and controller extensions that you might already know. Once SAP UI5 1.93 is the default production version, you will have access to the so-called Flexible Programming Model Explorer, which you can use to test and modify samples. You will find a link to this explorer in the blog post and on my Twitter and LinkedIn feed once available. Some of our community members already noticed this last week. the UI5 Inspector, our very popular extension for the Google Chrome web browser, is currently not available in the Chrome Web Store. But don't worry. The project continues and the team is working on fixing this issue ASAP. So please refer to the manual download and installation instructions on the project's GitHub page if you need to download the extension now.
Analytics Designer in SAP Analytics Cloud enables application developers to create centrally managed analytic applications, ranging from guided dashboards to extensively customized applications. These applications can contain many options for browsing and navigating data, changing visualizations, and navigating across multiple pages or areas. They can have a highly customized look and feel in alignment with custom branding. But how can you get started with the Analytics Designer? Where can you get samples? What are the best practices for designing analytic applications? If you have similar questions, then Analytics Designer Developer Handbook is available for you. It is a comprehensive guide that includes everything you should know. From the onboarding materials like basic concepts, widgets, and script APIs, to deep dive contents like typical patterns, best practices, and performance tips. Version 10 of this developer handbook has been recently published, and you can find the link to it, as well as information on what's new and changed in the blog post from Jason Young, the product owner. We are looking forward to seeing examples of great applications built on SAP Analytics Cloud by you.
There's a new blog post out with details of the August 2021 release of SAP Conversational AI. It describes features such as Initialize Skill, which has support for actions required at the start of a conversation, automatic determination of a user's language settings, custom styling, adaptive responsive design, and more. It also contains important information on data policies and deprecated features. Check out the blog post, which also contains information on how to get started with SAP Conversational AI.
Hi, I'm Svea Becker from the SAP community team. In my role as an SAP community advocate, I'm working with different topics around the community. Today, I would like to talk about Industry Cloud. Have you heard about it? Industry Cloud is SAP's strategy to extend the Intelligence Suite with innovative Industry Cloud solutions. They are built by SAP and partners, and of course, they are using products of the Business Technology Platform. Sounds interesting? I will recommend that you tune in the community because we have a brand new topic page. When you hit the blue follow button on the Industry Cloud topic page, you will get notifications if new content arrives in the SAP community. We also had recently an SAP community call about Industry Cloud. Kai Fink, who is the head of SAP's Industry Cloud, has answers to all your questions. So I recommend that you tune in the SAP community, and I hope to see you there.